This is my, I don't know, get home bin. My GOB Get Home bin. It's a blue, you know, tote, big tote. And it's got all kinds of crap in it. You carry whatever you want, you know, whatever you need. I can afford, and by that I don't mean money, I mean by space, I can afford to carry just a whole lot more. I mean, you can see it fits in the back of the truck there. And there's some stuff that I have that you won't even see because it's either in the cab or, you know, I carry an extra extra chain here for Chip. So I went ahead and chained him up. So there's some stuff you don't even see here. You always have water. And what I'm doing today is I'm just kind of re-designating some of this stuff. This pack is too heavy. And it's mostly because it has food. Well, I've already got food in here, but I'm going to go ahead and take this food and put in here. And I've got some cooking stuff that I want to put in another bag. So I'm just going to settle this someplace like this. And, you know, hope you can hear me and talk here. Like I said, you always carry your water. Let me turn this so I can see myself. You always carry your water, and I carry a bunch of it, and of course wait to treat it. I always have a couple extra towels just for peas and giggles. You carry your jumper cables and your, you know, some tools so you can do stuff with it. This is if you need it for your vehicle. This is a little three-stick chair that a fat man with a bad back needs. I carry a couple safety cones because I got them for $2 and I thought that is cool. So anyway, if you'll just bear with me, I may even put some music on here, I don't know, but I'm just going to go ahead and redistribute some of this stuff. Looks like I got some extra clothing and shoes. This was actually from a storm and I wanted to have it handy. One thing I do know that is coming out of this bag, and this is just a Walmart bag, you don't have to have anything fancy or majorly good, you know. This has got a bunch of stuff in it that it's a little first aid kit. Here, there's some toilet paper. See, here's all the weight. And this is a Leatherman and a flashlight that looks like I threw in here on a whim. This is all the weight. Now, I love these clear bags, and these bags come from, you know, sheet set, get a quilt, you get a bedspread, you get new pillowcases, and I save these. I got a ton of them. Rita puts them away for me, or I just stick them back in a drawer until I need them, and I love them because you can just look through your package and see what's right there. You don't have to go digging through. So let me put my toilet paper back in there, my first aid kit. This military poncho, and since I've got a raincoat in my bin, I'm going to throw this in here. You see, I've got a pair of gloves on here, so I can keep these in my storage. I think I'm going to put one of my hats inside. Now, the only thing in here that I really... You know, this has got a stove in it with some fuel, an alcohol stove with some fuel, and it's got a surround your alcohol stove, a windbreak thing in it, and some miscellaneous food. So I'm gonna leave that in that pack, I think. This is another stove set. So here's some of these bags I was telling you about. This is some oil, and you can see what happens to olive oil when it gets cold. It just, you know, goops up. Now it's still good. I mean, you just have to squeeze it out or cut the bottle or whatever. And I put this little cozy around it and just taped it up. It's plastic. So not only will it insulate it a little bit, you know, if the bottle were to get brittle, this isn't going to muffle the hits and bits and bruises. Let me see what I got here. A small one. This is like a size I'll use. But I've already got some other stuff in here. Pardon the garbage man coming there. My neighbors, we take our garbage and do elsewhere with it, but they use a truck. So I keep a raincoat handy. And you know me with knives, so I got a cold steel kukri. I've re-beveled the edge here to a edge more satisfactory to my needs and uses. And it's a good blade to have here to use. While we're on that subject, there's a little Gerber. This was a gift, I think, from somebody, and you know, it's a nice little you know, I wouldn't want to give my life to this, but handy little tool to have, easy enough to pack. Okay, here's where I'm getting into some food. Here's my 4-cup. I'll go ahead and show you here. It's a little percolator, you know, a little coffee percolator, so I can make my tea, or I could even use this for a, you know, for a cook pot. So I think it's got to stay aside. And here I have a mess kit, an Army mess kit, military mess kit from World War II. And it's got some stuff in it too. So this is going to go in my see-through food bag. I'm not going to go through all of this stuff, but I am going to go through enough of it to get myself situated the way I want. I'm sorry. I'm apologizing to myself. And that's key. You know, you get what you want to have in there. Again, as I said, I can have a lot of stuff. This is a solar panel to recharge, you know, phones and whatever else you might have. I got doggy bags in here. I got this little thing I got for 69 cents or something. It's a little just day glow pack. I got disposable gloves and a huge first aid kit. You want to mark that, you know, if you were to have to send somebody to your truck or something to get it. It's right there. I got a pad to lean on, I got plenty of fuel in here, I got some stove tops, including this little, never been used before, that I can sit over a fire, and actually I think it's for proofing, you know, set a drip pan on it. It's called a pan grate, so I don't know what the heck it is, but I know it was cheap enough. So I got that in there, tons of food. I like canned goods. There we go, we're getting to it now. More water. Okay, lots of food. This is where I'm gonna put these in this big bag. Alright, see this huge bag. Oh, you really can't see through it. Whoops, sorry there. You guys got hit by a rolling can of chicken and dumplings. Just to say, Kreider I get a lot of this stuff at the dollar store, and Kreider puts out a lot of stuff that, and it's good stuff. So, you can see what that drop did, but we're all right. Okay, all the food stuff's going in this big bag. This is peanut butter, canned goods, jerky in the bag. And this big bag I just showed you also opens up all the way down to the side. So, you know, I can basically open it up any way I want. And the thing is, with the Get Home bin, it's in my truck, so weight is not an issue. And I can always take from the bin and put in the pack and, you know, do something like that with it. Or I can set up, I got enough stuff in here where we can literally set up a camp, you know. And I don't have a tent, but I've got a couple of tarps. So we can literally set it up. And I'm going to go ahead and, I know I'm rambling, I'm going to go ahead and put this small one in this big thing here. My gosh, I don't think I'm going to be able to lift this. Alright. Solar, I'm keeping separate. This is a camp stove. This does not have a stove with it. Miscellaneous bag, you know, just different things, solar radio, lots of twine, deep twine cordage, even a plug in there, some extra gloves, some extra first aid, a little extra saw there, and I don't know if you can see an extra knife. So just a miscellaneous bag, which I can go back in just like that. This is one of those bags you get at the dollar store and you can suck out the air. So this has some clothing in it and stuff because I don't care if it's wrinkled. So I'm going to leave this like this. Now, in here that you cannot see, and that I'm not going to pull out. All right, pull this out. This is water, you know, where I can do my laundry. Or I could use this for dishes. That's a waterproof bag, you know. I could haul water in it. I could put, you know, whatever. Well worth to have. All right, here is a bag that you can see we've sucked the air out of. And it's just extra clothing, both warm and cool. So it's going to go right there. And this is going to go almost right along with it. I've got a... couple of tarps down here, and I've also got a in the bottom, and I've also got a moving blanket, nice and warm, you know, and you could lay it out if you wanted just for a picnic. I mean, whatever, you know. Here's some more miscellaneous stuff. I'm going to go ahead and put this in the pack. This is some tackle, fishing tackle, and I've got one of those little fishing rods because if I'm going to go fishing, I'm not going to fish for anything big. I'm going to go after, you know, some small stuff. So I don't need a big pole. I just need a little pole, and that's what I've got in there. It's a little 3-footer. This is a little bag you can get for your pet, you know, which you have to keep your dog or your cat if you're going to possibly bug out with them or whatever. This transfers into a bowl. And you can put water in here, you can put food in here, and we have one of these in his bug out bag, and as well as Rita carries one in her vehicle. And so anywhere we go, and Mr. Chips goes with us, you know, we have something to put his food and water in. Now this will get packed somewhat to the top, you know, because along with the, like, emergency toilet paper and crap like that. Speaking of which, there's your emergency toilet paper kit. You have a flashlight, you got plenty of tissues, you got the alcohol wipes, and you're good to go. You know, you can literally good. Did you get that? Good to go? Good to go. Again, you should know there's more tarps in here and stuff. This is a strop to keep my knife sharp. No, it's not a sharpener, it's a strop, but most of the time it's all I'm going to need. I also keep some doggy bags in here for his duper. When Chip's dupers, I can just bag them up, but bags are good for other stuff too. Keep a little Gerber multi-tool in the handle. It doesn't get lost. More water, because you can't have enough, right? And again, weight is not an issue for me. Cute, but it's something to kneel on. You know, you can always fan your fire, whatever you want. Weight is not an issue for me. When you're carrying when you've got a bin like this in your vehicle, it's not an issue. Now yours may not be this big. Maybe you don't have the space affordable to this. So maybe you'll just have a pack. Well, that's great. But have something for God's sake. You know, inside the cab, I've got, blankets. I've got a couple extra hats. I carry an extra jacket. And the jacket's with me summer or winter. It doesn't matter. Okay, so extra clothes there. So I think I'm going to put those extra clothes that we were looking at a minute ago on in here. Put my shoes in there. And if you're going to pack extra shoes, you know, like most of the time I'm going to be wearing probably tennis shoes. So I pack another pair of shoes that's a little more durable than what I need it to be. You know, they're tread safe, so they're going to feel good on my feet. All right. I got some more clothes in here. I want to get in here. This hat's got a buckle up. What do you call them? Yeah, that's a face warmer thing in here. And I'm going to go ahead and put my my clothes washing stuff in here as well. And this extra pair of gloves. Oh, bang, if I'm not dropping those dumplings again. Oh my God, it's one thing after another. I need a bigger tailgate. Jeez. Well, you can see why I covered up my olive oil can. Yeah. All right. So this is all clothes. And this is my solar kit. Let's see what's in here. See, that's the problem with bags like this that are closed. Now, this could also be a pillow. You could stuff this and be a pillow. But it's hard to see what's in there. And if you leave it in there for an amount of time, you just simply forget. Of course, once you see it, you go, oh, yeah, sure. Now, I've never used these, but there's been good reports about them. This is two each, a two-person bivvy. I'm going to take one out of there and put in this bag so that I have that. And I'm going to leave this in here. And then I'm going to go ahead and put this in this clothes bag. No, it's not closed, but, you know, I'll know it's in there. And the chances of me using that, if I were to use one, it would be, dang, blast it. That's a comedy of errors. If I use that, it'd be in my bag anyway. But I have to be careful. I don't want that bag to get too heavy. That's the curse. It doesn't need to be heavy. I got all this stuff in here that weight is not an issue. Still got this bag down here with food, and we'll put these chicken and dumplings in there, and I'm going to go ahead and drop that oil in there. Now I've got several cook systems here. These three items are all cook systems. And you want to put your bottles and stuff on top. You don't want a lot of weight on them. So here's the question. Again, big first aid kit. You know, there's all kinds of bandages on in there and whatnot. Inside this, I also have a smaller kit. I have some, you know, solar blankets, and I don't want to take it all out, but you can see it is like, I guess, big bandages, small bandages. I've got a lot of stuff in here. But you know, you never can tell. You might not need them. Somebody else might. Also, I keep the toilet paper on top because I have to pull over for some reason, which I hope I never have to face. I'm going to put my jacket back in here on top so I can grab it. I carry an axe. Carry an axe in a cab. So I like this, where I can get to it if I need it. I'm going to take this just in case, you know, Rita were with me and we needed an extra. I'll put it right in there. So here comes the question. This solar charger, well, the tackle needs to go back here with the fishing pole. And I think I'm putting the food in next. Oh Lord! Big bag of food. That's fine. Weight, not an issue. We can close this down. And this, now we know this entire thing is food. Under this food is clothing. Again, I'm going to bring the first aid kit out a little bit more on top. And I'm just going to, you know, I was going to separate these. I should show you this. In case you do have to go to the bathroom, you know, some people carry a little shovel. That's what this is, just a little dig yourself cat hole. It goes right close there too. Okay. So the question is, I don't think I can even get these all in there. I don't think they need to be. But I have two stoves in here, and they sit right there And, you know, I think I'm just going to put my coffee pot right in my bag. It will not make it too heavy. And, you know, then what I'll probably do is I'll probably go through this bag again and kind of sort it out. But I can tell you right now, just by feel, yeah, this is already about, I don't know, 6-7 pounds lighter. So, now, what I'll do is I'll push this back to the front of the truck, this bin, and, you know, the pack will go on one side, and the chair, and my jumper cables, and my cones, they'll go on the other side, and, you know, I'll cover the whole thing with those old towels there that I'll use for whatever. You know, if you come across a car accident or something, they sop up blood. I got a couple blankets in there, probably 3 or 4 different types of blankets. And then I've got, you know, one in the cab. And let's say I go somewhere to a park or something and I just, you know, want to go out. I can just take the bag. I don't take all this stuff. So yeah, I carry a bug out bag and bug out bin. Now, somebody wanted to see and asked, you know, what do you put to get home in? Well, you know, it depends. How far are you from your home? What do you anticipate stopping you from getting there? How long do you think it's going to take you to get there or wherever? Now, again, I have the luxury of having a little truck that I have plenty of space for. Weight's not an issue, so I can put whatever the heck I want in here, and I can feel so confident that if I were to break down in Timbuktu, you know, I could live for probably a week. And that's just on what I've got. That's not counting anything else. So, do I think I'm going to break down in the middle of Timbuktu? No. I don't even go to Timbuktu anymore. So, that's not the issue. The issue is, am I prepared? Now, maybe this stuff's not even for me. Maybe other people will, I'll parcel this out, you know, to somebody else who might be in need or something. And I'm not above or beyond that either. So, you know, but the thing is doing what you need to do in order to feel confident and secure in your environment. Staying alive. That's what it's about, you know, until you're ready to die. And then, you know, who cares?